Now let's look at the additional materials and tools which you might need. Let's begin with the tools to create a sketch. It could be a transfer pencil, chalk, or disappearing ink pen. Another type of applicator which could be used on fabric is some kind of sponge. This is just one example. They can be so many. It could be any type of sponge, even the kitchen sponge, if cut and prepared accordingly, could be beautifully used for creating really interesting effects on fabric. Obviously, we need paint and something to stir it and freshen it up with. So this is, you can see, it's the stick from the old brush for the mixing of paint or even its application to the palette. It's really convenient to use the palette knife. It can be any type, really. Now talking about palette, a really humble type of palette could be any type of cardboard wrapped with wrapping paper. Just as an example, I'm showing you use it. Once the paint is dry, for your next project, you can use the other side. I would definitely advise you against overusing the palette, meaning in case you have the regular type of plastic palette and you use it several times for your projects and even on top of the dry paints, just please don't do this stuff when you're painting on fabric, because simply the new paint can pick up the pieces of the old ones, which could soften up with the time, and it will just really mess your work. So using the singular use palette is the best choice to my mind, and after you took off the plastic, you can easily recycle it. Next, in case if you prefer not to or create a sketch by yourself, you can use a transfer paper. It's carbon paper, transfer paper, can be different names. So later there will be a separate video about the ways to transfer your image to the fabric, and in there we will talk about the transfer paper in detail. Now, when painting on clothes, it's really important that your illustration is at the right place. Let's say if you paint a bunny on a t-shirt, then you probably want it to be located in the center of your piece. So using the centimeter measure or a simple ruler will be really helpful, and the result of your work will look real professional and symmetric. Now moving on to the next helpful object. Would be the clips, either laundry clips or the paper clips of different sizes. These types of paper clips, they are really good because they have, you see here, like wider area to help us stretch the fabric on the board to which I'm gonna move next, and in order to make sure that the piece of cloth that we're going to be painting on is well stretched and is not moving during your work. You can use something like this, or if nothing fancy, just regular laundry clips, and your area will be just a little bit smaller, but it will do the job. I use them all the time. Next, since I mentioned already a board, we need some flat, properly covered with plastic surface, which we're going to place inside the garment or under the any sort of textile that you're going to be painting on, in order to protect the other side of the, let's say, some t-shirt, right? Fabric paint, when applied on textile, tends to go through the fibers, which enables it in later to bond with the fabric, and also it later tends to stain the surface it lays on. Hence, if it is a t-shirt, you can imagine that all the paint will be eventually on the back side of your cloth. You don't want that, and that's why we simply wear our piece of our cloth on this any type of cardboard. So I found it as a very easy thing to do and very like practically prepared material is the paint board, any canvas board, which is absolutely accessible everywhere. They initially already perfectly covered with the plastic, which is properly stretched, and it's not too thin, so it will not basically ever stick to your garment. And another thing is that we really need some very smooth surface, because the smoother the surface underneath, the smoother the surface will be on the inside of our clothing. And this is a very important point if we want the person who's going to be wearing this clothes to feel comfortable when the painted cloth is touching the body. I just want to mention that the size of this board will depend on the size of the painting that you're making. For example, this board, which is 25 by 30 centimeter, will be perfect for some t-shirt for a child, okay? But because it will be perfect for the size of the chest, right? So it's easy to wear it, and you don't really need to roll your fabric on the sides too much to make it flat. But let's say if the t-shirt will be for an adult, it's best to use a bigger size of canvas because you all the time would want your fabric to be completely flat. You don't want to, you know, arrange it, okay, I have only a small piece of board, so I'll just now paint this part and then I will move it down. So you need to prepare in advance a bigger surface, all right? So alternatively, you can just dedicate one or two pieces of canvas boards. Do not open them, just leave them like this, covered with plastic, and use them for different sizes and types of your projects. Next, I will show you as well my another favorite, which I'm continuously using whenever I'm painting for adults. But before I go there, I also want to explain why the board needs to be covered with plastic and we cannot simply use any type of cardboard, let's say from Amazon box. The reason is because the paint eventually, once soaked through the fabric, is going to stick to the surface, alright? But while you can easily pick it up later once the painting is dry off the board covered with plastic like this, you definitely won't be able to do so off any type of regular paper, let's say even thick watercoloring, like dance web paper, or off the cardboard, because the paper itself, the cardboard as well, is going to be get wet, and then it's going to stick to the back of your painting, which happened to me in the beginning of my fabric painting journey, and I was literally dragging off my t-shirt off this unprotected cardboard. Actually, it was an A4 paper, just a dense one. So when I was washing this t-shirt already, once my design was dry and it fixed, I kept, you know, removing this traces of paper for quite a few washes later, and believe me, that was not a nice view. Okay, so right now the last thing, last tool, the helper, which is very important when we paint on fabric, basically when we paint on canvas as well with acrylics, is a small piece of fabric. Some people are using a paper towel, but I'm very planet friendly and I try to avoid using too much of paper. And some old but clean fabric proved to me being more useful than a regular piece of napkin, because once, let's say, I take this type of brush and it's all wet, right, I will do it just once like this, that's it. The napkin will be gone, meaning it will be just, you know, completely wet. But it doesn't happen like this with piece of fabric. So now, to help you up with the whole list of these things, I prepared for you a checklist of the additional tools for painting and left the link conveniently under the video. It will be easy for you to follow through and have the checklist always handy, in the beginning at least, until you will memorize which things you need in order to be ready and start the action.